today I'm going to be utilising the leftover tropical barbecue chicken. And if I'm totally honest, it was a total triumph. I'm so happy that it turned out the way it did. And I'm definitely going to be putting that in my recipe book and on my website. I love inventing new recipes that pull off. They don't always taste as good as I think in my head they're going to turn out, but that one was quite good. Okay, so just wanted to be honest about that. So, and also what I didn't show on last night's video, but I did put in the description, is after half an hour or 40 minutes or so, I ladled out a lot of the stock, because what happened is the chicken released a lot of juices, and then you got a lot of the juices from the vegetables also. So I ladled out the stock, but then it turned out to be a bit of a blessing. So what I did is reduce the sauce down, mixed a bit of corn flour in there, and then sieved it, and it made like a lovely gravy to go with the couscous and the green beans, but you would have seen that yesterday. Okay, so today what I'm gonna be doing is utilizing that to make like a puff pastry pie. So I've got an addition of close cut mushrooms, some chives, spring onions, garlic, I've got a leek as well, and then I've got a little bit of halloumi. I'm gonna put some semi-dried tomatoes in there. I'm running quite low on ingredients today. And then just on the side, I'll use up the leftover tender stem broccolis that I haven't cooked yet. Okay, so let's get straight to it. Just gonna put the garlic in the pan, a bit of rapeseed oil. It's gonna be a very short video, a quick meal, okay? So most of the time is in the cooking. I've preheated the oven, gas mark 200, it'll probably be in there for what, 25 minutes or so? Okay, so I'm just gonna cook off that garlic, put the spring onion in there, that's all I've got. Okay. Turn that up high just to get the pan going. Okay, whilst that's heating up, I can chop these leeks, or this leek. There we go. Traditionally, you'd have like a chicken leek and mushroom pie with a bit of cream or creme fraiche or something like that, which tastes nice, and onions. But I want to utilize this barbecue chicken. I think it'll be nice. It's all like nicely slow cooked and in the sauce. It's got carrots still left. It's got not much peppers in there, but it's the red cabbage actually just almost like dissolved in when it cooked, because I actually ended up cooking it for quite a long time, maybe like an hour. So that's what was needed to really reduce it down and get that crispy skin on the chicken. Okay, so let's just chop these leeks up a little bit more, just to speed up the cooking process. They will cook obviously in the oven as well. So just put them in there. If there's any scraggly bits, just rip them up in the pan with your hands, that's totally fine. Yeah. And I just thought halloumi, normally I wouldn't put it in, but I just thought, what else could I put in there? I don't have feta, I don't have ricotta cheese, or anything like rocconi or anything like that, like soft cheese, but I thought halloumi might taste quite nice, add a little bit of bite in there. And then obviously when you cook it down, it goes a bit soft as well, a bit chewy. It's a nice contrast and texture maybe. You've got the softness of all that. And then the oniony-ness of this, and then maybe a little bit of saltiness and firmness from the cheese would be nice. Let's wait and see. Okay, so I'm just going to sweat that down, and then quickly in here, I'm going to grind up some spices. So I've got beetroot powder, bit of ground nutmeg, and then some marjoram, dried marjoram, okay? And then a bit of oregano as well. And then some pink peppercorns. just a little pinch of that. Just grind that all up. Like almost like a nice pink powder. And that will like make go really well with the richness of that dark brown sauce as well. I mean, whatever you've got available at home, I'm just going to put that mixture in there, straight in. Whatever you've got at home, so if you've got like some lamb or pork chops or even like some chorizo, or you've got you know, some salami or anything like that, that would go nicely in this. Just add a bit of meatiness to it. Depends what you like, really. I wouldn't recommend putting any like fish in this dish though. But you never know. Unless you try, just experiment when you're cooking. That's how you discover meals that work, you know. If you're always playing it safe, then you're never gonna discover like new meals. Okay, I'm just gonna put a bit of this stock in. It's almost like a ready sort of like sauce now. So trying to change the way it tastes and looks as well, okay? So my wife doesn't actually know what I've cooked or what I've utilized. She might know. Okay, so let's just scoop this in. Might not even need all of this. Quite a lot left. Might save some for tomorrow's lunch. Nah, let's just use it all. Put it all in. There we go. No point saving a little bit. And put the mushrooms in. Just roughly chop these. Quite small. Probably use like maybe five. Quite big mushrooms. What would be nice as well, like if you had like tiny little baby button mushrooms, and then fried them in a little bit of butter with a bit of garlic. If you weren't utilising this dish, obviously, that would be nice, wouldn't it? Because then they shrink right down into like tiny little mushrooms, whole mushrooms. You don't need to cut them. Just going to cook this for a couple of minutes, and then we can scoop it into this dish, and then I'll put the puff pastry layer. It's already pre-rolled. I didn't make it myself today, so I'll just put a thin layer on top, so it's like almost like a pastry hat on it. Yeah. This is great. Look how much food. It's almost like a full pan. So in goes the halloumi. I'm going to chop this quite small, okay? Just chop it into like little, tiny little cubes, I guess. Give that a little poke there. And then in goes the last ingredient, a couple of these semi-dried tomatoes, and that's basically all there is it. All there is to it, really. It doesn't really matter how many you put in, just a few, because they're quite strong. And also, I'm going to try and utilise them for another day, I guess, you know. Don't want to use up all my ingredients. that's it, turn off the gas, and now I'm ready to put that into the pan, into the pot. Just careful as you do this. I don't have a spoon, all my spoons are in the dishwasher. Just unroll it and then put it over the quiche, the slot.
The quiche.
I did make a quiche before, over the pot. Okay. So. It's very sticky, this pastry. And then once you've done that, then you can just roll that off like so. And then any excess, obviously utilize that as well, okay? And then kind of just like set, drape it into the edges of the pot. You know, you don't want to cut it too tight, otherwise it will just shrink and then sort of like, you know, just float around in the middle. If you give it a little bit of slack in there, almost like crimp the edges slightly, then it allows for a bit of it, shrinkage. Okay. That's it. And then I'll just trim off like slight the massive overhangs. Okay. I'm not going to be too precious on this. Like it's almost like it's a bit of a rustic pie, you know. Just put a couple of little pricks in there in the top just to help it breathe, okay? And I think that's all there is to it. So I'm just going to put that in the oven for 20-25 minutes. Gas mark 200. Set the buzzer. Here we go. And I'll show you a picture once it's plated up.